Hey everyone, Haley here. Today, I'm going to teach you how to make your first video in Biteable. Let's get started. Start off by logging into your Biteable account. There's two ways to get started with your video. You can edit any of our templates, or you can start from scratch. For this demonstration, we'll start from scratch. Choose your video shape and choose whether or not you'd like your custom watermark feature turned on or off. Then click continue. Now you can start building your video. You can see all of our folders of Biteable animations. Go ahead and click into any of the folders. Once you find the animation you like, click on it and it'll be added to your video. You'll see it pop up in the timeline at the bottom. Once you're ready to start editing, click anywhere in that timeline. If you decide you don't like that animation, simply click replace background and then you can replace it with any Biteable animation or any of our stock footage. Click on the image or video that you'd like to replace it with and then it'll be popped into your video. You can also replace the background by following the same steps and uploading your own image or video as well. Here we'll just upload a simple welcome image, and then once it's uploaded, it'll be added into our video and replace the original image. You can use the handles on the side of your image to resize so it fits a bit better in your video. Now let's get started on editing our text. Click anywhere in that text box and you'll have access to our properties panel on the right-hand side where you can do things like add ribbons, change text colors, and add text animations. To edit your message, simply click anywhere inside of that text box and begin writing your new message. You can also use the controls in the timeline here to either shorten the length of your text by dragging to the left or extending the length of your text by dragging to the right, and you can reposition where your text appears in your scene by dragging around. You can use this up arrow to add things like a logo caption, duplicate the caption, or delete your caption altogether, and you can use these plus bars to either add a new caption or the trash can to delete the caption as well. Now we're going to go ahead and add a scene with an animation, so I'll show you how to change the colors within that animation. To do this, simply find any of the animations in our diverse work stack or our services explainer stack, and then click into your scene to begin editing. Once you click on the animation, you'll see you have all of these animation color palettes on the right-hand side. Click into any of the colors that you'd like to change and select your new color. You can also add in a custom hex code here if you'd like to add in your brand colors. Now we're going to practice adding a logo or an image, and there's a few different ways to do this. We're going to click Add Scene, and then we're going to upload our own image, and this image will be the full background of our scene. So we'll just upload that same welcome image again, and once it's loaded, it'll be added into a new scene in our video, and it will take the full background of the scene. Then we'll be able to add text and captions over top of that image. So once we click into our video, we can use these controls on the timeline to delete any of our duplicated scenes. And you'll see here we've got that image now added as an entire background. Now we've changed our mind. We're gonna click replace background and instead we're going to choose a Biteable animation and then upload the image alongside the animation. To do that, again, pick any of our animations that you'd like. Once you click on it, it will be added into your video and it will replace the background photo that we just uploaded. We're going to click Add Caption and add a logo caption. Then we're going to add a logo and upload the photo that we want to have added into the scene. Then we can adjust the frame, remove the shape, add a background color, and either expand the size of the image or make it a bit smaller and drag to reposition on your screen. You can follow those same steps to upload a logo for your video as well. Now let's practice using the timeline. We have different scenes in our video along the bottom here. You can use the up arrow on your timeline to have controls like replace the background, duplicate your scene, or delete the scene altogether. Similar to the text, if you drag your timeline to the right, it'll make it longer, and if you drag your scene to the left, it will make it shorter. We also have a zoom feature, so you can zoom all the way in to edit with precision, or zoom all the way out to see all of your scenes at once. You also have the option to add scene transitions. Once you've selected a scene transition, you'll see this icon gets colored in. To change that transition, simply click again and pick your new transition. Next up, we can add audio to our video by clicking the Choose Soundtrack button on the bottom left-hand side. Here we have over 80 different royalty-free soundtracks for you to choose from. Click the play button to preview any of those songs, or you can upload your own music as well. Once you've found the music track that you like, click on it, then click save, and you'll see it added to the bottom of your video. If you want to change the audio at any time, simply click on that soundtrack bar again and pick a new song. Now to preview your video, you can play from anywhere within your video by clicking wherever you'd like to play on the timeline. Or you can use this large play button on the left-hand side to start playback from the beginning of your video. Now once you're happy with your finished video, go ahead and head over to that Export tab, and then click Build Video. Here you'll be able to add a call to action. This feature is available on our Ultimate and our Teams plans. You can go ahead and add in an optional message for your call to action, and you can add in the messaging on the button, then add in the website link that you'd like your call to action to link to. Then you'll have a clickable call to action at the end of your Biteable video. We also have access to our Biteable analytics, which are available if we share with our Biteable link. Once you click into those analytics, you'll be able to see things like views, engagement, and if you have a call to action, you'll be able to see how many people have clicked on it. To share your video, you'll be able to download, share with a link, or share to social. Congratulations! You've officially finished your first video with Biteable. If you're ready to get started on the next one, head on over to our template library at biteable.com/templates. Bye!